أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين.
I am number one, baby you can call me a superman. Chochote utataka nitakupa.
Hey guys, welcome back to our channel.
It's your boy Jesse Keegan.
And you go Fanny Lungu.
And we are Fanny and Jesse. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction. But before we get into the reaction, guys, we want to thank everybody who's been subscribing to the channel. You're the realest MVP. And thank you so much for the people who've been giving us reactions. You keep us going, and also you're the realest MVP. So right about now we're gonna do another reaction. This one right here was suggested by a lot of people, and they decided that we should go react to Surah Yasin, extremely powerful Quran. So without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مقمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون وسواء عليهم أنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون إنما تنذر من اتبع الذكر وخشي الرحمن بالغيب فبشره بمغفرة وأجر كريم إنا نحن نحيي الموتى ونكتب ما قدموا وآثارهم وكل شيء أحصيناه في إمام مبين واضرب لهم مثلا أصحاب القرية إذ جاءها المرسلون إذ أرسلنا إليهم اثنين فكذبوهما فعززنا بثالث فقالوا إنا إليكم مرسلون قالوا ما أنتم إلا بشر مثلنا وما أنزل الرحمن من شيء إن أنتم إلا تكذبون قالوا ربنا يعلم إنا إليكم لمرسلون وما علينا تطيرنا بكم لئن لم تنتهوا لنرجمنكم وليمسنكم منا عذاب أليم قالوا طائركم معكم أئن ذكرتم بل أنتم قوم مسرفون وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين اتبعوا من لا يسألكم أجرا وهم مهتدون وما لي لا أعبد الذي فرضي
فطرني وإليه ترجعون أأتخذ من دونه آلهة إن يردني الرحمن بضر لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا لا تغن عني شفاعتهم شيئا ولا ينقذون إني إذا لفي ضلال مبين إني آمنت بربكم فاسمعون قيل ادخل الجنة قال يا ليت قومي يعلمون بما غفرني ربي وجعلني من المكرمين وما أنزلنا على قومه من بعده من جند من السماء وما كنا منزلين إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم خامدون يا حسرة على العباد ما يأتيهم من رسول إلا كانوا به يستهزئون ألم يروا كم أهلكنا قبلهم من القرون أنهم إليهم لا يرجعون وإن كل لما جميع لدينا محضرون وآية لهم الأرض الميتة أحييناها وأخرجنا منها حبا فمنه يأكلون وجعلنا فيها جنات من نخيل وأعناب وفجرنا فيها من العيون ليأكلوا من ثمره وما عملته أيديهم أفلا يشكرون سبحان الذي خلق الأزواج كلها مما تنبت الأرض ومن أنفسهم ومما لا يعلمون وآية لهم الليل نسلخ منه النهار فإذا هم مظلمون والشمس تجري لمستقر لها ذلك تقدير العزيز العليم والقمر قدرناه منازل حتى عاد كالعرجون القديم الشمس ينبغي لها أن تدرك القمر ولا الليل سابق النهار وكل في فلك يسبحون وآية لهم أنا حملنا ذريتهم في الفلك المشحون وخلقنا لهم من مثله ما يركبون وإن نشأ نغرقهم فلا صريخ لهم ولا هم ينقذون إلا رحمة منا ومتاعا إلى حين وإذا قيل لهم اتقوا ما بين أيديكم وما خلفكم لعلكم ترحمون وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين وإذا قيل لهم أنفقوا مما رزقكم الله قال الذين كفروا للذين آمنوا أنطعم من لو يشاء الله أطعمه إن أنتم إلا الله في ضلال مبين ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين ما ينظرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون فلا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون ونفخ في الصور فإذا هم من الأجداث إلى ربهم ينسلون قالوا يا ويلنا من بعثنا من مرقدنا هذا ما وعد الرحمن وصدق المرسلون إن كانت إلا صيحة واحدة فإذا هم جميع لدينا محضرون فاليوم لا تظلم نفس شيئا ولا تجزون إلا ما كنتم تعملون إن أصحاب الجنة اليوم في شغل فاكهون هم وأزواجهم في ظلال على الأرائك متكئون لهم فيها فاكهة ولهم ما يدعون سلام قولا من رب رحيم وامتاز اليوم أيها المجرمون وامتاز اليوم أيها المجرمون ألم أعهد إليكم يا بني آدم أن لا تعبدوا الشيطان إنه لكم عدو صراط مستقيم ولقد أضل منكم جبلا كثيرا فلم تكونوا تعقلون هذه جهنم التي كنتم توعدون اصلوها اليوم بما كنتم تكفرون اليوم نختم على أفواههم وتكلمنا أيديهم وتشهد أرجلهم بما كانوا يكسبون ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ومن نعمره ننكسه في الخلق أفلا يعقلون وما علمناه الشعر وما ينبغي له إن هو إلا ذكر وقرآن مبين لينذر من كان حيا ويحق القول على الكافرين أولم يروا أنا خلقنا لهم مما عملت أيدينا أنعاما فهم لها مالكون وذللناها لهم فمنها ركوبهم ومنها يأكلون ولهم فيها منافع ومشارب أفلا يشكرون واتخذوا من دون الله آلهة لعلهم ينصرون لا يستطيعون نصرهم وهم لهم جند محضرون فلا يحزنك قولهم إنا نعلم ما يسرون وما يعلنون أولم يرى الإنسان
الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة أولم ير الإنسان أنا خلقناه من نطفة فإذا هو خصيم مبين وضرب لنا مثلا ونسي خلقه قال من يحيي العظام وهي رميم قل يحييها الذي أنشأها أول مرة وهو بكل خلق عليم الذي جعل لكم من الشجر الأخضر نارا فإذا السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون.
Sorry guys, our camera went off, so we decided to charge the battery. It took us like almost like 2 hours or something. As you can see, there's a change of setting. The video was amazing. I thought it was just a nice Surah Yasin. It caught me in the beginning where I started by saying that wisdom, like riches or rich is wisdom. I mean, what do you understand by that? Does it mean by you being rich is just having wisdom, or is it just a metaphor, something like that?
Should be a metaphor, because life is really not about material things. I don't know what you think it means.
Because I think I was listening to something the other day, and it was saying that it was facts about the Quran, or facts about, I don't know what that was, but it was saying that riches was mentioned more times than poverty. Get it? Like, it was mentioned 26 times, then poverty was mentioned, I think, in the Quran. Riches is mentioned 26 times, and then poverty is mentioned 13 times. So that led me to an understanding that Allah doesn't want people to languish in poverty or something like that, which resonates with this surah here, Yasin, in the beginning. Like, riches, wisdom. Probably it's I don't know if it's the same or it's a metaphor. Probably it might be a metaphor.
But then God has given us everything. Why should someone be poor?
Yeah. But again, if you look at the word rich and poor, people have their own interpretation.
What's yours?
Being rich, I mean, it's being alive and being able to have the elements of virtue, you get it, not vice. I mean, the thing is, if you apply virtue in your daily life, I think you're already successful, you're already rich. And also, by doing that, I mean, favor will come to you, and you'll be able to see, I mean, blessings. And by blessings, I mean, people will start looking at you as a very important person, a very helpful person, and then they'll be able to lift you up either way. That should be either in financial status or any other kind of way. So I feel like it's riches shouldn't be more materialistic. Sorry, should be more of,
I don't think it's material, because there's something we're reacting to, and I think it made clear that the poor help the poor. Why is it that the poor are the ones that are willing to help others? That shows richness in itself.
Yeah, that's richness.
The act of giving to someone, even when you don't have, stands for something.
just like the more
you I think if you notice, even like in these rich countries, do you know that the rich people don't want to pay their tax?
Mm-hmm.
Because that money for tax is given to the people that need it.
Oh yeah.
That's why you find maybe Justin Bieber is being caught because
he hasn't paid taxes.
Yeah.
Or Lil Wayne has been jailed because he doesn't want to pay his taxes. I mean, all the stories that you hear on the news or something like that, which is sad, anyway.
Because it's like the world has been divided into, or not the world, people have been divided into two, the believers and the non-believers. According to the video, there's something that you always say, and the video also made that point, the disbelievers said, why should we help others? Why should we help feed others when God can feed them? You know, there's always that point that you make saying, why are people suffering when there's God that exists?
Mm-hmm.
That's why I always tend to you and tell you that at the end of the day, it's us that are doing this to ourselves.
Yeah, it's
God
us.
Has given us this beautiful planet, but then want to destroy each other, then what?
Yeah, because there's just a group of people who decided that let's make these people suffer and let's make these people flourish. You get it? So it's so sad to see such kind of that kind of antics. It's really mesmerizing, you get it? Because if we start looking at things that way, then I think we will have people who will be growing up start looking at other people as bad people, or maybe you start seeing small children being conditioned at a young age. You get it? That's what you find nowadays. You find people. Why are people growing up hating rich people? You understand? Why are people growing up hating poor people? You know, you get it? It's because of just the mentality. It's because of, we think that rich people are dangerous people. Rich people are probably the Illuminati, or probably they're into this, you know. Which is not what you think. Some work their way up. They struggled enough to have that amount of riches or that amount of wealth. Which it shouldn't be a problem to anybody else to start hating or start looking at them like you're bad people. You get it? No. Even the same way applies to the rich people. You shouldn't look at poor people. Once upon a time, you are at that level. You get it? You're struggling to. Yeah, not all of them. Some were born in a silver spoon. But.
Roles can change any day.
Yeah, I mean, roles can change
up,
any day. Yeah.
Tomorrow you're down.
Exactly.
Right?
So
you're down, the other day you're up.
The best way is to give. The more you give, the more you receive. As in, if you look at these countries, like for example, I can give an example, like, let's say, the other day we talked about, why are they successful? You get it? Is it because they give so much? Muslims, or maybe people from the Middle East, you understand? Or maybe just Muslims. Why? Because most of them are successful. Yeah. If you look at it, like, they give so much, and then they, in the Bible, there's a verse that says,
they love each other. They respect
yes.
the culture.
Yeah. Exactly. But I'm trying to go to. When you give so much, the more you receive. That's the verse in the Bible. You get it. I think it also applies to the Quran too, probably. I mean, if you have the act of giving, and don't look at it like don't look at it like you want somebody to reciprocate that. No, just look at it like, in my native language, we say tender women in Dazako, like. Do good and then just walk away, you get it? And it's more of a good act, because one day Allah, God, is going to reward you with something big. I mean, if you practice that, it's going to be a very good If you feel like you reacted to this video in a better way, give us a thumbs up. And don't forget to go down our comment section and tell us exactly what you feel about that reaction. And what you feel about this video that we reacted to. This is Surah Yasin. Just let us in the comment section below. What do you think about the video? And if you have anything that you need to add on, just let us know in the comment section below. We'll be really glad. And if you have any other, if you have any reaction video, just let us know too. And the most important thing, guys, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The more you keep subscribing, the more give us the motivation to do a lot of videos and to give you a better content. And last but not the least, we're going to see you in the next video. And peace out.